Dan Illman, Matt Bernier, race number 7 at Santa Anita on Sunday is the Grade 2 Monrovia Stakes. We are going 5 furlongs for fillies and mares, and you're going to want to get involved with your DRF Bets account. When you deposit $100 with DRF Bets, you get to play with $250. Learn more at bets.drf.com. Let's meet the field of filly and mare turf sprinters getting set to go 5/8 of a mile in this year's Monrovia. Safe to say the trainer Peter Miller has an extremely strong hand with the two favorites on the morning line. We'll begin with the number 8, Belvoir Bay, a millionaire that ran so great on the Dubai World Cup undercard, just to be beat a little bit more than a length. And her race 2 starts back, the Wishing Well, over this course and distance. She hammered 4 of these common foes, and it looked like she never really got out of a canter that day. On her best, she's the one to beat for sure.
No question about it. She's the filly to beat in here, or mare, I should say. She's 6 years old. She's just rock solid. You know, more often than not, she's going to come with her A game. You brought up that Elquaz sprint. She ran too well to lose that day. That run 2 starts back in the Wishing Well, where she humbled a number of common opponents here in the Monrovia. If she runs back to that race, either of those two for that matter, she's probably just going to win this race. I think the beautiful thing about Belvoir Bay is that versatility. If for some reason the pace is slow, she can go. If for some reason it does heat up and there is an honest pace, she is just as effective sitting off of a target. You have to view her as the horse to beat.
Painting Colors is the second choice on the morning line. This is a late developing mare trained by Peter Miller. She just scored last time out in the Misdirection Stakes. She has already graded stakes play, so she has shown her quality in this division. Last time out, she looked really good winning that race at odds on. The field hasn't come back strong, but check out this formulator fact over the past couple of years. Last out winners going 2nd off the layoff in turf sprints, 7/12 over a $5 return on investment. And you know Painting Corners is going to be forward, if not outright on the lead.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of a stunner to me when I went through this race. 5/8 of a mile on grass, you expect to see a bunch of horses that want to go right to the front. And I think there are horses with nice tactical speed in here. The only real burner in here, in my opinion anyway, is Painting Corners. I think she's going to go. There's one way for them to go. That Misdirection, I basically look at it as a carbon copy. You're going to go out there, try to bottom out the field and say, come and catch me. The difference may be, as you alluded to, is a chance that that Misdirection, the quality may be why she was able to hang on. I think she's facing better horses here on Sunday.
Well, let's see what Timeform US has to say about the pace situation in this year's Monrovia Stakes with the Timeform US pace projector. And as Matt mentioned, there's that blue bar in Timeform US parlance that favors horses on or near the early lead. And Painting Colors is expected to make the lead, which would make her doubly dangerous in this spot. Rocky Policy, directly inside of Painting Colors, is 2nd on our Timeform US pace projector. She came from off the pace to score when in for a $40,000 tag last time out, but she was flattered when that runner-up came back to win with a 90 buyer.
Yeah, I was going to say Kenton Road came back, earned that 90 buyer in the next start. There's a situation where I look at it and say, at 7 years old, maybe we've already seen what her best game is. Maybe, you know, it's going to be enough to get a minor award. I'd be a little bit surprised if she were able to win in here. But keep in mind, her runs at 5/8 of a mile, I know she's only 1/9, but she has gotten involved with some minor awards. I wonder at a bigger price, maybe that's where you can use her.
Trainer John Sadler is very well represented in this race. Let's talk about the number 5, Ginger Nut, who's going to have to overcome an unfavorable pace scenario, according to Timeform US. But that's exactly what she did last time out at Keeneland over good going at 5 furlongs. They really weren't going that fast early. She came from far out of it with a good, strong run. She has always shown a lot of promise. I think this 3-year-old filly is pretty good, and this is a confident spot taking on older fillies and mares.
That was the thing that kind of concerned me a little bit. Boy, she's going to be going into the deep end here against some really salty older fillies and mares at this distance. I like everything about her. I liked her in the Gulfstream race. I like her in that race at Keeneland. And I kind of feel like if she was going to get a fair pace situation, I would have improved her position here instead, because I think the pace could potentially compromise her. I'm only going to use her underneath.
Sadler also trains Lady Subi in here, and I'm willing to give her the last race at Churchill Downs. She had to deal with shipping. She didn't break very well, and I'm just going to throw that race out because she just seems more consistent than that overall, looking at her past performances. The issue is 3 back, 4 back. She ran into Belvoir Bay. She couldn't beat Belvoir Bay.
Yeah, that's kind of the way that I look at it. Boy, she's already kind of been exposed against some of these girls, not only Belvoir Bay, but a little bit me in that most recent run as well. And like you say, maybe you want to forgive that run at Churchill, but I look at it and say, I think she's just a notch or two below.
Richard Baltus has a few entrants in this field. Let's begin with the 6, A Little Bit Me. He also has the 9, Gliding By. They share the same formulator fact. Over the past 3 years on turf, last out winners going third off the layoff, the Baltus barn winning a 28%, a 321 ROI. A Little Bit Me won that race at Churchill Downs last time out, coming from off of it. It was a nice rock solid effort at 5.5. Do you think 5's a little short for her, especially with this pace scenario?
Yeah, hard to argue. She's 1-for-6 at it in the past, 3 times a minor award winner, so maybe she just gets the engine cooking a little bit too late in a 5-furlong race. Maybe she needs that extra half furlong or even an extra furlong out to 6. I think she's okay. I just kind of want her to prove to me that the 22-to-1 win wasn't a fluke.
As for Gliding By, you and I have always been fans of hers, going back to her career debut way back in 2015 at Woodbine when she was trained by Josie Carroll, and she has won 2 of her last 3 races for Baltus, but I kind of think she's kind of found her niche in that optional claiming. The 62 fives, the 80s, this seems like a big step up in class, but she has a little bit of tactical speed.
The other thing I find interesting about her, I picked her 3rd. I wanted to toy with the idea of picking her on top. Just frankly, I'm not sure she's good enough to win a race like this. But keep in mind that most recent run was her first time at 5/8 of a mile. And I think that could be a major differentiating sort of factor for her going forward, because she really finished like a house of fire. It was just when she was finally hitting her stride. I wonder if she's just ultimately been better at 5/8 as opposed to the longer distances all along.
When S.Y. Sky is right, she fires each and every time. She has never been off the board from 12 lifetime starts. She has won half of those races, including last time out at Golden Gate Fields where she sat off the pace. She has more speed than that if Drayden Van Dyke opts to use it.
She does. I have to be honest. I just look at her and say, I think she's going to be better off against Calbreds or in those really minor stakes races like the one we just saw up at Golden Gate most recently. I think she's nice. I just think this is going to be a little bit of a tough spot.
Matt Chu has thrown a lot at the number one poster girl in her last few races. Seasonal debut going 5 furlongs. She dumped the rider at the start. Then she stretched out to 1.25 miles, and all things considered, she was a little overmatched in the Santa Anita. The distance was probably too far. I think she ran that badly when she was next to last. Then they cut her all the way back to 5 again, and she came with a run behind Painting Corners last time out. I just thought Painting Corners ran the better race, and if Poster Girl's going to have to come from off of it again, she has to deal with that negative pace outlook.
Well, and that's the thing. Boy, she had the pace to run at last time. The horse that was setting the pace was Painting Corners, and she still couldn't run her down. I think with a more advantageous pace situation for Painting Corners this time around, it's that much more difficult for Poster Girl.
The 3rd Baltus entrant is the longest shot on the board. That is the number 7, Flametta, at 30-1. This is a nice, honest horse, but she is cutting back significantly in distance. And while I do like the Wildcat Airs as turf sprinters, I just have a feeling she's going to be out-sprinted early, and I think there are better closers in this race.
Can't help but think she's going to have a ton of running to do when they turn for home. She's probably going to be last trying to make a bid. Hard to recommend for me right now.
Let's take a look at our top selections for this year's Grade 2 Monrovia Stakes at 5/8 of a mile. Hey, it's Peter Miller's world and we're only living in it. You're going with Painting Corners. You're going with the better price and you're going with the horse that can be controlling the pace. I think Flavian Pratt's going to realize that this pace might not be so fast and he's going to get Belvoir Bay into the race early and it could be you and me turning into the stretch.
And if that's the case, I probably think Belvoir Bay is the one that you want because I think she's just a better horse than Painting Corners. But if for some reason they are more content sitting off of it saying, you know what, we still think we're just that much better than a horse like Painting Corners, I don't think you want to let her get too far ahead of everyone else because, again, you don't have a lot of time to go and run them down. If they are a little bit more aggressive with Belvoir Bay early on and she's the one that presses it, things, I think she's probably a more likely winner. I think Belvoir Bay is the most likely winner. I'll give Painting Corners a look, though, 4-8 for me.
I'm going to go 8-4 in the Grade 2 Monrovia Stakes. It's race number 7 at the Great Race Place on Sunday. Get involved on all the action at Santa Anita. Nice card this Memorial Day weekend, Sunday, and of course Monday with the 3 big Grade 1s. Deposit $100, bet with $250. DRF bets, ready, set, bet. Approximate post time for the Monrovia, 4 o'clock Pacific. Good luck.